It's a production thing. She comes by the neurosis naturally.
You're in the back.
You're in the back?
Yeah.
How are you guys?
Good.
Good.
Yeah, that's much better.
Sunglasses down. First day of kindergarten, last day of graduation.
Graduates, please be seated. Thank you for being here tonight. Now that we got our graduates seated, it's time for everybody to stand while the young Marines install our color and Mr. Purdy plays our national anthem.
Thank you.
please remain standing. Thank you, young Marines. Thank you, rockin' Mr. Purdy. Now, we're gonna be led by Hunter Clark with the Pledge of Allegiance. Ceremonies in the past, and I'm proud of the quality of young people our fine school produces. I have been fortunate to work with many of these students, and they have touched my heart. We have enjoyed many conversations, some fun, some not so fun. We have endeavored together to outlast the pandemic. Many of these seniors have just now recovered from their recent trip to Disneyland for grad night. Yeah. All of our graduates have completed high school coursework, turned in their last portfolio, and passed their final exams. This is cause for celebration. These students have been on a journey that represents 13 years of school. It has been our pleasure at Valley Oaks to be involved with assisting families in this important endeavor of education. Thank you for choosing us to make this journey with you. I also want to welcome our dignitaries that are here on stage. We have our County Superintendent, Dr. Mary Barlow. We have our Associate Superintendent, Dr. John Mendenburg. We have our Assistant Superintendent, Desiree Von Flew, and our Director, Deanna Downs. Now it's our treat to hear from Dr. Mendenburg.
Well, good evening, seniors. How are you? Good. Ready to be done with high school?
Yeah.
Yeah, see, now the truth comes out. Ready to be done. But you're going to start a new chapter in your life. And for many of you, that's going to be different colleges, career paths. Wherever you go, you're going to succeed. I'm proud to be here today representing Dr. Barlow and the entire Kern County Superintendent School's office to congratulate every single one of you. Valley Oaks is a very special program in which all of you have gone, some from kindergarten, some from middle grade, some from just high school. But wherever your path has taken you to this point, it will continue to take you as you move on to your next steps. You know, we just experienced the last couple of years of unheard of times of period in education. And all of you persevered, all of you here tonight because of that perseverance. Remember that as you continue to move forward. Hopefully you're in a program in a school where you don't have to deal with the train anymore, but you keep persevering. And you keep doing what you need to be doing. All of you are going to be very successful no matter what you do, what path you take.
Thank you, Dr. Mendenburg. Who needs to silence their cell phones when we got a railroad? Now we get to hear from part of our senior class, our graduates, starting with Grace Bumatai.
Good evening, everyone, or hey, if we want to be a little less formal. My name is Grace, as you just heard, and as I'm sure you've guessed, I am a graduating senior today, and I am here to speak on behalf and to the graduating class of 2022. Well, seniors, we've done it. We're all here, we're all wearing our caps and our gowns, and we probably have too many family members or well-wishers out in the audience, but what can I say? They're proud of us. I'm proud of us. Look how far we've come. Now, before I get too deep into my speech, I just want to let you know, I'm going to do my best to keep it short and simple. I know many of you, including myself, are going to forget what I'm going to say here, so I'll try to keep it quick. I want to say congratulations. Congratulations to the class of 2022. Thank you.
Thank you, Grace. That's just our sheriff helping us to feel safe. Next, we'll hear from Huda Al-Rohani.
Good evening, faculty, staff, family, friends, and my fellow 2022 graduates. I would like to begin by saying thank you. Thank you to our teachers, staff members, and parents for supporting us.
Thank you, Huda. Our next graduate speaking is Natalina Gerber.
How do you want to change the world? They ask us all, faculty, parents, and students alike, and expect stereotypical answers. The responses typically vary from make everyone feel loved to give everyone food, and even as far as find a cure for cancer.
Thank you, Natalina. Now it's my privilege to introduce our valedictorian, Callie Elizabeth Steinwain, as she sings Gloria Estefan's Reach.
Thank you.
Thank you, Callie. Valedictorian, and now she owns the loading dock. Some of our graduates will be honored with distinction from our nation's presidents. I will share the guidelines for these awards. For the President's Award for Excellence in Education, the purpose of this award is to recognize academic success in the classroom. To be eligible for Educational Excellence Award, students must earn a grade point average of at least 3.5 and score at least 1.4 and 1.3 on the STAR test. For President's Award for Educational Achievement, the purpose of this award is to recognize students that show outstanding educational growth, improvement, commitment, or intellectual development in their academic subjects. Also, for a student who demonstrates achievement in the arts, such as music or theater. It is meant to encourage and reward students who work hard and give their best efforts in school, often in the face of a special obstacle to their learning. The American Citizenship Award is for students who meet at least four of these five listed qualifications: outstanding participation in school and/or community service, positive attitude towards classmates, display an understanding and appreciation of civic responsibilities, possess strength of character, encourage to do what is right, and also promote citizenship within the school or community through a variety of activities. This describes many of our students. As many of you know, our school traditions include a very dignified graduation ceremony. I would like to remind everyone that today the well-deserved focus is on our graduates. Please listen carefully and hold your applause as the graduates' names are called and special comments are spoken as they walk across the stage. Feel free to then applaud these fine young people after they receive their diplomas. Thank you for your consideration, cooperation, and assistance in helping to make our graduation a very special event. Presenting the diplomas tonight, again, we have Dr. Mary Barlow, Desiree Von Flew, Dr. John Mindeborough, Deanna Downs, our director, and our counselor, Ms. Jenna Liske. And reading all of the students' names and the words about them is our own rockin' Mr. Purdy. Let's go ahead and proceed.
Okay, first up, Johnny Acosta Jr. Johnny attended Valley Oaks for 3 years and is now a proud high school graduate. Jared Arnold. Jared has attended Valley Oaks Charter School for 13 years and is excited to be graduating this evening. He is most proud of his senior seminar project on the history of gaming consoles. One of his fondest memories was dunking Mr. Shelton in the dunk tank at Extravaganza. Now that Jared has graduated, he plans to get a car and enter the workforce. We wish you the best in your endeavors, Natalie. Isabella Cisneros. Isabella enrolled at Valley Oaks her 10th grade year and is happy to be graduating tonight. She was involved in the newly formed Valley Oaks High School Film Club and enjoyed learning about and critiquing movies while making friends who have the same interests. Isabella is not sure of her career path at this time, but the staff at Valley Oaks wish her the best of luck in the next chapter of her life. Hunter Clark. Hunter has attended Valley Oaks Charter School for 7 years and has earned the Citizenship Honor Award. He is proud of the academic accomplishments and the friendships that he has made. His fondest memory was being involved in the ballroom dance club. That is where he met his best friend. After graduation, Hunter plans to work at his family's business and continue his education. He also plans to expand his photography skills and is looking forward to traveling. We would like to wish him the best in his future endeavors. Congratulations, Hunter. Eric Daniels. Eric has attended Valley Oaks Charter School for 8 years and is able to finish high school a semester early. He plans to pursue a career as an architectural engineer. He has many fond memories of high school and is excited to start the next chapter of his life. We wish him the best on his journey. Good luck, Brack. Emily Zepeda. Emily has attended Valley Oaks High School for 4 years and is excited to be a high school graduate. Her proudest moment was giving her senior project presentation and feeling accomplished. One of her fondest memories was attending grad night with the class of 2022. Those memories will last a lifetime. Emily has a passion for animals and caring for them. After graduation, she will continue to explore opportunities to move into animal care as a career. The staff at Valley Oaks wish you the best in your future endeavors. Let's go ahead and give all the graduates a big round of applause.
We should give another round of applause to Rockin' Mr. Purdy. Thank you all for another great graduation ceremony. We would like to ask the audience to please remain seated as the graduates proceed out. Graduates, please stand. Turn around and face your audience. Side of your mortarboard. I take much pleasure introducing to you the highly esteemed Valley Oaks class of 2022. Congratulations, graduates. As you proceed out, find your places. For the locomotive to honk. Just one thing, over here in the garden area, there is a congratulations graduate sign, one for each, and we want you guys to be sure and take those yard sign home if you would like. And once again, congratulations, and audience, you are dismissed. Find your graduate.